do you think about as a science educator when you think about this awesome eclipse that we're going to get to see on August 21st?
That's a great question. You know, I think about what the kids know, and I think about really young kids who have a hard time understanding that that objects in the sky just don't stay in the same place that they're moving. So some kids just think that objects appear or disappear. They don't really think of them as moving across the sky. So that's something that I think about, having kids understand that. And the eclipse is one way to help students begin to understand that idea.
Is there anything else that you think about?
Yeah, you know, I'm really trying to think about how we can get kids to make explanations from evidence. And the eclipse is a great opportunity to do that. We can have kids model the eclipse. So you can give the kids three balls and have them try to come up with an explanation about what's happening. And they can match that explanation with actually what they see on eclipse day. So they can get evidence from the eclipse to look at the adequacy of their model and revise it. And I like that because I think that's something that scientists do. Scientists think a lot about models, and they always collect evidence and try to judge the adequacy of their models with the evidence.
And interesting, that's maybe where mathematics and science meet here in this case, because when you're making your models, those proportional relationships between, for example, the size of these bodies matters.
Yeah, yeah, I think you're absolutely right. You know, mathematics and science are really important. They work together, don't they?
They sure do.